State 3. To kick it off. It is deep. Moore back at his 15, moving to his left. Retreats back to the 15, trying to set up the wall. Now turns the corner on the Bobcat side of the field and is pushed out of bounds up across the 25-yard line.
Push out of bounds by Billy.
Well, the Bobcats will start it trailing 7-3. One thing we should remember here is Reno scored going into the wind. The Bobcats had it on the Reno 25, the wind at their back, and didn't get anything. The Bobcats now with the wind to their back for the final 8:50 here in the third quarter, trying to make something happen as they will have it on their own 25-yard line. Wilkinson and Reinhardt in there behind Tatrall. Moore in the slot right. Wide to the right side is Bergman. Tatrall option right. Tries to pitch it. It's fumbled, and he goes back, tries to get it. Does he get it? No. The Wolfpack has it on the fumble at the 20-yard line of MSU.
Again, I think, Dean, it was penetration by the defensive line of Reno, causing a problem in John making his read there. And like we said, it's really a detriment to an option team to allow penetration.
So the Wolfpack with the first down of the Bobcat 20-yard line, a big break for them. As Zakeo gets the play call at the sidelines and hustles out. Reno with a golden opportunity on the fumble recovery. Ego goes wide left, Logan in the slot to the left. Williams, wing back, right side. Folger, the lone setback behind Zakeo. Williams, or rather Davis, the tight end on the right side. Zakeo rolling right, wants to throw. Cox the arm, now going to keep it, and is pushed out of bounds by Micklewright inside the 20, down at about the 18-yard line.
Good coverage, John Fields, the Bobcats, by Rob Hatch that time, covering the receiver that Zakeo wanted to get the ball to and forced him to turn upfield and try to make the best out of it that he could.
So Zakeo with the call, second down and 8. Ball on the Bobcat 18. Logan wide left. Igu out to the right side. Williams and Folger, split backs behind Zakeo. And the give is to Folger, trying to come back up the middle. Gets down inside the 15 to maybe the 14-yard line. Bringing up a third down and about 4. Corey Widmer in there along with Michael Kemp on the stop for the Bobcats.
A couple other scores this afternoon in the at halftime. Nebraska over Kansas State 34-3. Arkansas leading Houston in the third quarter 19-14. Michigan over Indiana in the first quarter 7-3.
Logan wide right, Igu wing back left side. Folger and Williams split backs behind Zakeo. Igu in motion from left to right. Zakeo on the give to Folger, trying to go to the right side. He'll be wrapped up by Wanego and company and pulled down back at the 15-yard line. John Wanego got the penetration, just wrestled him down from behind, and that'll bring up a 4th and 5, and that will bring on Lucas Adriani for the field goal attempt.
As you talked about earlier, Dean, I think this would be a questionable chance for success here with the Reno kicker with his previous attempts.
The 32-yard attempt for him. He is 2 out of 4 from this distance on the season. From the right hash mark into the wind. Ball is down, the kick is up, and the kick is not good, not good. So the Bobcats get a break, when he shanks it. And I guess you would say that there was no damage done there after the fumble.
Well, I watched Chris Ault on the sideline that time, Dean. He didn't hesitate making the decision to send his field goal kicker out. Maybe next time they come to that choice, he might hesitate a little bit.
Great job by the Bobcat defense there. Getting out of there with no points on the turnover deep in their own territory.
Reinhardt and Wilkinson in behind Tatrol. Moore wide left. Bergman wide to the right side. Travis Annette is the center. Tatrol on the option left side. Going to keep it, and he will be dropped for about a one-yard loss. As wrapping him up is Mike Lazovich. He elected not to pitch, elected to keep it. Lazovich elected to tackle him for about a one-yard loss. Second down and 11 of the Bobcat 19.
Almost like maybe he was just a little bit gun-shy that time because of the fumble on the previous play to pitch the ball.
Bergman wide right, wide to the left side is Watson. Hagerberg and Wilkinson in behind Tatrol on the second down call. Give straight ahead and out across the 20 to maybe the 21-yard line is Wilkinson. And there isn't much there for him. So it'll bring up a third down and long for the Bobcats. Third down and just about eight. Bobcats with the wind at their back. We have 6:15 and ticking. Time remaining in the third quarter. Nevada-Reno leading at 7-3. Wide right is Bergman. Wide in the slot right is Watson. Spokley and Reinhardt in there behind Tatrol with the third down call. Tatrol rolling right on the option, wants to throw, throws, completes it to Watson, out across the 30, up to the 34-yard line, and that's enough for the first down. Nice catch by Watson. He was pounded immediately, but he had more than enough yardage for the first down.
Watson just going upfield, about 10 yards, looking in, nicely thrown ball by Tatrol that time. The Wolfpack defender giving a little bit of a cushion to allow the completion.
So the Bobcats with a new set of downs. First down from the Cat 34. Wide left, Bergman. Slot left, Moore. Tight end left side is Grace. Reinhardt and Wilkinson in behind Tatrol. Option left side. Rolling left, fakes the pitch, keeps it. Lunges out across the 35 up to about the 37-yard line. He'll pick up about three. Second down and seven. Tatrol making the right decision that time on the option, elected just to keep it and not risk the wide pitch. He'll send Bergman wide to the right side and Tony Moore to the left side, which is the short side of the field. He has Hagerberg and Wilkinson, the setbacks behind him. Rolling right, wants to throw, fakes the throw, now lets it go down the right sideline, has Bergman out of bounds over his head, incomplete. Back defending for the Wolfpack is Bernard Ellison.
Same play we saw earlier in the first half, Dean, where he pumps on a short route to Pat Bergman. He makes the fake and then heads up field. And again, the Reno secondary not fooled on the play.
So the third down call.
Bobcat offensive line, Dean. Now, Ken Iden has moved into the right guard position. Derek Isaacson moves from the right guard position over to the left guard position in place of Brian Ratzberg.
Slot right. Watson in the slot, Bergman wide right. Option right, Tatrol rolling right. Giving ground, now going to keep it, and he'll be snowed under back at the 35-yard line. He'll lose yardage as he had no place to go and no one to throw to. And so the Cats will have to punt it away.
Again, a good job that time by Reno of really stringing out the option. There was Tatrol and his trailing back and about five white jerseys just running step for step down the field with him.
They'll mark it at the Bobcat 36. Quinn Falk on to punt it away. Joel Long is the long snapper. Gets it up high and carries well away from Logan. Hits and bounces, and it will be pulled down by Scott Kimball back about the 24-yard line. So that's where the Wolfpack will start at the 24-yard line. First and 10 for Reno, leading at 7-3. Here late in the third quarter, 4:10 remaining. The offense comes on for the Wolfpack, the defense on for the Bobcats.
40-yard punt for Falk that time with no return.
Kerwin and Kimball. Pulliot and Curley. Skelton and DeAugustino. Hatch and Kemp. Nicolwright, Winnego, and Widmer for the Bobcats up front. Give to Foger straight ahead, and he'll get out across the 25 to maybe the 26. And that is all he will get. John Winnego right there for the Bobcats. This is the way it has been all afternoon, as the score would indicate. A struggle by both sides, against one against the other. 7-3, Reno with the lead, though. As Logan comes way wide left, Ego out wide to the right side. Mikhail with a 2nd and 8 call from the 26-yard line of the Wolfpack. Throws out in the right flat behind Ego. Ego was curling in. The ball was thrown an out pattern, and it's incomplete. It'll bring up a 3rd down and 8 for the Wolfpack.
A little miscommunication there between the quarterback and the receiver.
So, once again, we've had a ton of these this afternoon. The big 3rd and long calls for both sides. Ego out wide to the left side. Wide to the right is Logan. Davis, the tight end left side. The Bobcat fans fired up. One of that defense to stop him right now on the 3rd down call. Zakeo straight drop. Getting pressure. Running away. Rolling to his right. Pressure again. Lets it go up the sidelines. And it is caught by Williams. And he'll be punched down at the 40-yard line. The Wolfpack 1st down for Reno. Well, Zakeo got loose long enough to throw it. And there was Williams out of the backfield up the sidelines for the catch.
Well, he did a great job of finding the open man. The coverage out there was John Skelton, but John was 10 yards in front of Williams. Williams over there almost literally by himself, and Skelton had to hustle up from behind to make the tackle. Big 3rd down conversion for Reno.
Zakeo, a nice little scrambler, and it paid off for him that time. Logan in the slot left, wide left is Ego. 1st down for the Wolfpack at the Reno 40-yard line. Give to Foger. He'll get across the 40 to maybe the 42, possibly the 43. Trying his right side. See where they spot the football. They'll give him just about 3 yards on that. Call it 2nd down and 7. The Wolfpack, of course, here in the 3rd quarter going into the win. Doing a good job of maintaining possession of the football, looking for that big 4th quarter, the wind at their back. Slot left formation, Logan in the slot, wide left is Ego. Zakeo, quick drop, wants to throw, looks out on the left, and it is batted away. Or did he lose it? They rule it a fumble. Get a signal, it is a fumble. They rule that he tried to throw and just lost it. And the Bobcats recover the fumble. That is Michael Kemp with a fumble recovery. I thought it had been swatted away, but they say he just lost it.
It's like he wanted to fake the pass. He pumped the ball, and instead of bringing it back down, the ball went directly into the ground. It was a loose football. Big break for the Bobcats.
1st down for Montana State at the 22-yard line of the Wolfpack. And that wakes the fans up again. Slot left, more in the slot. Berkman wide to the left. Wilkinson and Reinhardt. Give straight ahead Wilkinson inside the 20, down to about the 18-yard line. He'll pick up about 4. Call it 2nd and 6.
Well, you talk about the word momentum in this game, and we do have an injured Reno player down. I think the momentum has now switched back into the Bobcats' favor a little bit. Big break for the Bobcats.
I think that's Todd Deeds, the inside linebacker. While they check him out, we'll check out. 2:01 remaining in the 3rd quarter. It's Nevada Reno 7, Montana State 3. Back after this. We'll be right back. Wildcats. Second down and 7 from the 18-yard line of the Wolfpack. Straight ahead, Wilkinson. Inside the 15, down to about the 13-yard line. He's going to be very, very close to the first down sticks. Bobcat. Bob Wilkinson is busting it up front.
Bobcat offensive line has really been doing a good job of firing off the snap of the ball and getting their blocks. There's nothing fancy about what they've been doing the last two plays. It's a matter of just giving the ball to the dive back and get some blocking from the offensive line.
Third down and less than 1. Wide right, Bergman. Slot right is Watson. Spokley and Reinhardt in behind Tatrault. Tatrault on the give to Spokley, and he breaks it down inside the 10-yard line for the first down. The Cats will be looking at a first and goal. Pat Spokley hanging on and just pounding it down inside the 10.
Bobcat offensive coaches apparently last three plays have been the dive play of the option, just putting the ball right up the middle, running tackle to tackle, and apparently Reno doing a good job of stringing out the option, so the Bobcats are just going to take the dive and continue
call
to run it.
The 8-yard line. Wilkinson and Reinhardt in behind Tatrault. Give to Wilkinson, and he will push it for a yard or so, maybe down to the 7. Seeing where they unstack him down there. Up off the bottom of the sack for the Wolfpack, as per usual, Mike Lazovich. He's in on about everything. Has been all season, leading tackler for the Wolfpack. They'll spot it at the 7, second and goal from the 7. Bergman wide right, Moore in the slot right. Wilkinson and Hogeberg in there behind Tatrault. Tatrault on the give to Wilkinson, has some room, spins around, and will be just shy of the goal line, down near the 1-yard line.
Tremendous block that time by Brian Ratzberg back in the game at left guard. He really blew out the snap of the ball, and a big hole for the back.
Wilkinson. Almost, but not quite, and that'll be the end of the third quarter. At the end of 3, it's Nevada Reno 7, Montana State 3, back with the...
KUSM-TV, Channel 9, Bozeman, Montana Public Television.
Down, the kick is up. Kick is good. 93 in a row for Anders Larson. Bobcats 10, Nevada Reno 7, 14:59 remaining in the game. Back after this from set to kick it off, leading it 10-7, 14:59 remaining in the fourth quarter. Judy gets a low liner. It's down inside the 20, picked up by Igu there, and he comes up the sidelines, and wham, he is leveled by Steve Lebsack. at about the 24-yard line.
That was a collision of number seven running into number seven down there.
Nice pop by Steve Lebsack.
Great drive for the Bobcats, Dean. Six plays, all six plays, they kept it on the ground, and they did nothing whatsoever fancy. They just utilized primarily the dive option of their triple option, got some great blocking from their offensive line, and the beauty of the whole thing is they're doing it against the number one rush defense in the Big Sky Conference, at least coming into the game.
Well, through three quarters, the Bobcats have rushed for 169 yards against the Reno, which is about twice as much as they were giving up per game coming into this one. Zakeo with a long count, and he's got a lot of movement there. And then finally gets a handoff, going forward for maybe a yard.
That was a little counterplay there, and that just took too long to develop in the backfield. Mickelwright and Winnego both breaking through the line of scrimmage and getting to the ball carrier about the time he got the handoff.
Williams on the carry. I thought there might have been movement before the snap. Second down and nine from the 25 of the Wolfpack. Logan wide right, Igu to the left side. KO again, the long count. Straight drop, wants to throw, looking down the right side, throws it, and it's complete to Logan. And he is bumped out of bounds up at the 49-yard line. And that'll be a first down for the Wolfpack. Just went in and squared out. And Zakeo put it right on the money. Nice catch by Logan.
That was a beautiful play to watch. That's something obviously they practiced a lot, because Logan running the little square out, he only had about 5 yards to work with. Zakeo had to make a perfect pass to get it to him before he stepped out of bounds, which he did.
He was averaging about 20 yards a catch coming in and almost got 20 on that one. Zakeo with the first down call. Rolls to his left, wants to throw, lets it go out on the left flat over the head of Igu. Kerwin over there defending for MSU. Incomplete, second down coming up for the Wolfpack.
It appears Chris Alt and the Wolfpack are using the wind at their advantage. They're having at their back throwing the ball here the last two plays.
Ball at the 44-yard line of Nevada-Reno, second down and 10. Bobcats leading at 10-7, 14-10 to go here in the fourth quarter. Igu wide to the left side, Logan wide to the right side. Williams and Foger split behind Zakeo. Davis tight end on the left side. Zakeo rolling left, getting pressure from Kimball, now getting pressure from Hatch. He'll be sacked back inside the 30-yard line. Kimball from one side, Hatch from the other. Nickel right up the middle, and a big loss for the Wolfpack.
Kimball and Hatch that time are what they call alley players for the Bobcats, and both of them came blitzing in from their outside linebacker positions, and Zakeo just didn't have anywhere to turn to.
Let's pause 5 seconds for station identification. You're on the Bobcat Radio Network. Third down call for the Wolfpack from the Wolfpack 30-yard line. Zakeo, straight drop, wants to throw, has some time, steps up, comes deep over the middle to Logan, and he is knocked down and throws the ball incomplete. Kimball and Foliot and DiAgostino there, and that'll bring up a fourth down for the Wolfpack.
Well, I would say definitely momentum is riding with the Bobcats at this point in time.
They're a fired up bunch, to say the least. Reinhardt, the single safety, back inside his own 25 for the Bobcats. Chris Duran with the wind at his back will punt it away. Gets a good snap. Gets it away, gets it high. Reinhardt back for it at his own 23, moving to his right to the 25, to the 26, and that's all he'll get. As trying to turn the corner and get outside, couldn't find the alley to get upfield. He's wrestled down, but the Bobcats will have it, and they'll start with the lead, 10-7, 13:09 remaining here in the fourth quarter. And the offense going into the wind here for the rest of the ball game.
43-yard punt that time for Duran, about a 4-yard return for Wilkinson. The Bobcats had the rush on that time, coming with 10 men, got awfully close to the punt. 10 men obviously rushing the punter, left Reinhardt back there by himself to make the best of the situation.
Bergman wide left, Watson slot to the left side. Datrell on the give, up to about the 30-yard line, just shy of the 30-yard line. Olbert in on the stop for the Wolfpack, as Wilkinson is the ball carrier for MSU. Give him about four on that, make it second and six.
Bobcats continue to primarily here the last couple of series of downs have been running between tackles, keeping the ball inside.
Wide right, Watson, wide to the left side is Bergman. Tatron with the second down call. Option left side, pitches it back to Wilkinson, trying to get wide, gets out across the 30, up to about the 33-yard line. And the June bug pulls him down. Mike Brown, senior out of Vallejo, California. They'll spot it just across the 32-yard line of MSU.
Tatro a little slow getting up that time. As a matter of fact, he was helped up by his right guard, Kent Iden, limping back into the huddle. But he is going to stay in there.
Third down and four for MSU. Reinhardt and Templeton, the setbacks behind Tatrol. Slot right formation, rolling right. Tatrol just keeps it, and he'll only get a yard or so, and that's all. And the Bobcats will be forced into a fourth down punting situation.
At the end of the third quarter, total offense, the Bobcats with 223 yards, Reno with 232 yards. For the Bobcats, Hagerberg, three rushes for 81 yards. Reinhardt, seven rushes for 18 yards. Reno. Fulger is 16 rushes for 85 yards. That was through the third quarter.
Logan, the single safety, back for the Wolfpack inside his own 35. Falk to punt it into the wind. Snap is high, but he has time. Kicks it high, then it hangs up, and it will bounce in front of Logan. Take a Bobcat bounce down inside the 35, and it will be knocked down dead at the 31-yard line. First down for the Wolfpack from the Wolfpack 31. No return on that punt either.
Very difficult to field those punts, as we said in the first half with the wind blowing. Even more difficult when the wind is at your back. You're trying to field the punt that's coming into the wind. And like we said, it can have a knuckleball effect and very hard to judge where it's going to be.
Kevin Wolf back in the lineup. He's been back in the last two or three series for the Bobcats on the defensive front. That's good news.
Fulger and Williams split backs behind Zakeo. He has Igu in motion from left to right, leaves Logan split off wide to the left side. Davis tight end right side. Zakeo with a pitch. Back to Fulger, trying to get out to the right side. Does get outside. Gets to the sideline, tiptoes, and is pushed out of bounds in front of the Wolfpack bench. And then a flag is thrown.
Blake hit on Mark DiAgostino.
So that'll give the Wolfpack some good yardage on the personal foul call.
The thing is about it, Mark tried to avoid the hit, too. He just, I think, touched the ball carrier as he went out of bounds.
Well, you're both running full tilt. It's kind of hard to pull up there all of a sudden, but the official was right there, and that's the call. So that'll put the Wolfpack down in Bobcat territory. So they pick it up and march it off. That'll put it down to the Bobcat 42-yard line. First and 10 for the Wolfpack.
That time, Dean, Fulger showing his great ability. He is throwing the toss from the quarterback and just kind of strings it out to the side, waits for an opening, and just accelerates through that gap. And great job of balance and strength by Fulger.
In motion, Igu right to left. Logan split out wide to the left side. Zakeo on the give to Fulger, straight ahead. He'll get nothing. Absolutely nothing. Tried to dance a little to his right and go straight ahead, and there wasn't anything there. John Winnego sliding over for MSU. Second down and 10, no gain.
John Winnego again having a great afternoon at that nose guard position for the Bobcats. They just have not had a heck of a lot of luck running up the middle. Reno has it.
Second and 10, Logan wide left, Igu wide to the right side, the short side. Williams and Fulger split backs in behind Zakeo. Zakeo, play action, now stops, wants to throw, has a lot of time, throws out in the left flat, it is incomplete. Pulley out over defending, again off the hands of Demetrius Davis, who has had a long afternoon trying to catch the football.
A long afternoon for the tight end from Reno. Again, that's a play action pass where they're showing the run counter, and it takes a long time. He goes and reverses his field. The tight end drags across the middle, And good coverage by Rob Pooley out on the tight end.
Through the third quarter, Zacchaeo was 11 of 24, so not having a best afternoon passing. But as you say, Dean, a few of the passes have just been plain drops.
Third and 10 for the Wolfpack from the Bobcat 42. Igu wide left, Logan to the right side. Zacchaeo with the call. On the draw to Folger, and he has room. And will be caught up with and dropped as he gets down outside the 35-yard line of MSU. Not enough for the first down. It'll bring up a fourth down. He had some daylight early, but the hole closed quickly as the Bobcats gathered and pulled him down at the 37-yard line.
Something we've seen from the Bobcats so much this year, Dean, is just that tremendous pursuit that even on a play like that that looks like it's going to do something, they quickly cover and close the hole.
Kerwin, the single safety back this time for the Bobcats. Not so sure they're convinced he's going to punt it, but he is. Lifts it up high, and the Cats are just going to let it hit. It hits in the end zone. So the Bobcats will get it back on the 20-yard line. First and 10, MSU. Another stand by the defense. And the fans love it.
It'll be very important, Dean, for the offense to hang on to the ball, use some time off the clock, and not let Reno have many more opportunities on the field offensively.
9:36, time remaining in the fourth quarter. Bobcats leading it 10-7. Cats with the football at the Bobcat 20-yard line. Bergman wide left, Moore split wide to the right side. Tatrol, straight ahead give to Reinhardt, finds some room, crawls out across the 25-yard line. Help pushing the way for him is Mark Woodcock.
Bobcats continue to just run the ball between tackles, take that dive play, and pick up 4 or 5 yards. In that case, 6 yards.
Second down and 4 for MSU from the Bobcat 26. Moore wide right, Bergman wide to the left side, outside tight end Joel Grace. Augerberg and Wilkinson in there behind Tatrol. Cats going into the wind. Bohannon is the center. Tatrol, option right side, just keeps it, cuts up inside, and will be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Just shy, about a little bit more than the length of the football. So we'll call it third down and 1 coming up.
Some more scores. First quarter, Oklahoma State trailing Missouri 7-6. University of Washington trailing Oregon in the first quarter 7-0. Final Pitt over Navy 52-6.
Third down and 1 for MSU. The ball just across the Bobcat 29-yard line. Tatrol on the give to Reinhardt. He has it out across the 30, up to about the 33-yard line. Up and over the stack.
Boy, when the Bobcats have needed the yardage this afternoon, they have gone to the left side of their offensive line. Brian Ratzberg, Mark Woodcock over there on the left side, and they have gotten it too this afternoon.
Ball to the MSU 33-yard line. First down, Bobcats. Wide left, Bergman. In the slot left, Watson. Time not a factor yet. Cats leading 10-7. Just over 8 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. Tatrol on the give to Wilkinson. Finds some room. Will we get up near the 40-yard line? He'll pick up about 6. Be a second down and 4. Making room for him, Ken Iden. Second down, MSU. The clock continues to run, as we've talked about many, many times. This sort of offense is the kind you want when you have the lead and the football.
And time running out in the game.
You bet. Just eat up a little bit of yardage and a whole lot of clock. Wide left is Bergman, and the slot is Watson. Tatrol with a second and short yardage call. Second down and 4. Tatrol option left side, going to keep it and be spun down for a loss. Back near the 37-yard line.
Bonzel and Hulbert.
As the Wolfpack getting the good penetration, Bill Bonzel in there along with Neil Hulbert. And they will spot it back at the 37-yard line. So it'll be a third down and 6 for MSU.
Well, this is the Bobcats had run 5 plays in this drive. That last play was the first time they've tried to go wide. And again, Reno doing a very good job this afternoon defending the Bobcats running wide the perimeter game.
More wide right. Bergman wide to the left side. Tatrol with a third down call for the Cats. Option left. Pitches it to Bergman. Wants to throw. Going to pull it down and run for it. Trying to turn the corner. He does. Across the 40, the 45, up near the 50-yard line. Brad Bergman had the option. He could have thrown. He saw a wide open field. He kept it and kept on going. Out there in front of him was Ken Iden, who did a heck of a job. He needed that block, and he got it.
Well, the first option on that is to pass the ball, and he had Tony Moore downfield, but Tony Moore was well covered, and Bergman did the right thing. He tucked the ball up and got the block and turned it up to pick up the first down.
He did elude one tackler, too, that was out there and did a great job of cutting right when that guy was about ready to hit him, and thus got the first down.
From the 48-yard line of MSU, first down, Bobcats. Wide left, Bergman. In the slot left is Moore. Patron with the first down call. Straight ahead to Wilkinson. Finds some daylight inside the 50, down to the 46-yard line. The Bobcats with a nice gainer on the first down will be looking at a second down and three.
You said it, Dean. Getting 6 and 7 yards a crack on that first down play makes that second down call a lot easier to make for the Bobcat coaches.
And we're under 6 minutes. Time remaining. Cats leading at 10-7. Cats with the football at the 46-yard line of the Wolfpack. Hagerberg has some daylight. Could he go? 15, 10, touchdown, Steve Hagerberg.
Well, that time he took the dive play. It's the third time we've seen it. He broke into the secondary. There was only one man between him and the end zone. That was Mike Brown. And Hagerberg turned on the jets and beat Brown into the end zone for the touchdown. And Steve Hagerberg, he's only got 4 or 5 rushes this afternoon, and he's got to be up around the 120, 130-yard mark.
That was a 46-yarder that time. Anders Larson on for the extra point attempt. Hagerberg, 4 for 127 yards and one touchdown. Larson's kick is up, and the kick is good. 5:43 remaining in the fourth quarter. Montana State 17, Nevada-Reno 7. Back after this from our network and local sponsors. Judy to kick it off. The Cats leading 17-7.
Dennis and Lowell Springer, Bozeman Trophy, again presenting a special award to the MVP of today's game. Bozeman Trophy and Engraving, your complete awards and engraving center.
Almost into the seats. The wind kind of picked that one up.
For the Bobcats, it was an 8-play drive. They started on their own 20-yard line, so it was an 80-yard 8-play drive. It took them about 4 minutes, so it really took some time off the clock. Steve Hagerberg with the 46-yard run for the touchdown.
Last week, a potent offense of sorts. Broncos of Boise, 7 points thus far with 5:43 to go in the contest. The Nevada-Reno Wolfpack only picked up 7.
Yeah, Bobcat defense doing a great job here. We talk about what's going to happen here at the rest of the game. It's going to be up to the offense, the Bobcat offense, after they get the ball back, say if Reno does score or if they do hold them, to hold on to the ball and just not make any costly turnovers at this point in the game.
Well, another thing for Reno, they need 2 scores to do anything. So even if they do score, they can't take very long doing it or they could be out of luck. Judy will kick it from the 30 this time. Low liner bounces. They picked up by one of the upbacks. Side the 30 to the 35. He'll get across the 40. And that is about it as the Bobcats are there for the tackle. It'll be nice field position for the Wolfpack.
One thing, too, that's really impressed me this afternoon in the Bobcat defense is the hits that they have gotten in. You know that the Nevada-Reno players are walking off the field thinking about some of the pops that they've taken this afternoon, which has got to make them just a little bit tentative, particularly now where they're in a situation where they have to throw the ball.
Igu wide left, Logan wide right. The Wolfpack trailing 17-7, 5:37 remaining. The ball on the Wolfpack 41-yard line. Kale with the call. Straight drop, wants to throw. Getting pressure, throws a screen to Folger. Penalty flag is dropped as he makes the catch and is stopped up at the 49-yard line. Ball is loose, fumble. The Bobcats have it. They say they do. What do the officials say?
Matt Mickelright making the tackle from behind that jarred the ball loose for the Bobcats. It's just going to be a matter of whether or not he was down.
What do the officials say? They're talking about it.
Well, they're talking about the holding call, I think, first and foremost against Reno.
That's the call, holding against the Wolfpack. No fumble. Ball was blown dead. So the pass completion will be for naught. That'll move it back to the 31-yard line of the Wolfpack. Give them first down over. And as Paul mentioned, this is where you got to watch it because you're desperate. You want the quick score, and you put her up, and somebody picks her off, and then you are really dead in the water. Wide left, Ego. Slot left, Logan. Split backs, Foger and Williams behind Zakeo. Davis tied in right side. Zakeo straight drop again to throw, has time, lets her go deep down the middle, has Davis, he drops it. No, he has it, and he gets out of the pack, and he'll score. I thought the way he slowed up, he had dropped it. So he finally holds on to one, and he gets the touchdown.
Well, that's exactly what you don't want to happen. It happened against the Bobcats. You don't want to give up the big play, the quick strike that quickly puts Reno back into the game.
Well, I thought he was maintaining his consistency and had dropped it with the hesitation there, but he came out of the pack and he still had the football, and he'll go in for the score.
Not only did he come out of the pack and still have the football, but he managed to break a couple of tackles to get into the end zone for the touchdown.
And it only took the Wolfpack 34 seconds after they got possession to score.
69-yard pass completion.
Adriani on for the extra point attempt. The ball is down. The kick is up, and the kick is ugly but good. 5:03 remaining in the contest. It's Montana State 17, Nevada-Reno 14. To kick it off. It's high and deep. Curley and Moore are going to let it hit in the end zone, and then they will down it there, and the Bobcats will start at the MSU 20-yard line.
Well, the last time the Bobcats had the ball, they put together a nice eight-play drive and had the ball for better than 5.5 minutes, which would be just about right for a drive this time around. That would run out the clock, but my guess is Dan Reno is probably going to be up there challenging the Bobcats to put the ball in the air a little bit.
Yeah, I'm sure they will. They'll want to stop the running game. They'll be trying to strip the ball carriers and try to get the ball back.
Wilkinson and Reinhardt behind Tatrault. Moore wide right. Bergman wide to the left side. They give to Wilkinson. Lowers his head out across the 25. They pick up about 5 yards. The second down and 5. Augerberg comes into the huddle. Reinhardt checks out. You can bet they've been told one thing: hang on to the football.
That's for sure, Dean.
Wide right Moore, wide left Bergman. Gray's tight end left side. Wilkinson and Augerberg in behind Tatrault. Tatrault on the give to Augerberg. Straight ahead across the 30 to about the 32. First down, Bobcats.
Nice block again that time. They went to the left side of the line. Brian Ratzberg with just a very nice block that time. And alongside of him, the left tackle, Mark Woodcock, doing a great job all afternoon for the Cats.
Augerberg over 130 yards now on 5 carries. That is a nice afternoon, to say the least. Billy Templeton in, along with Reinhardt, slot right formation. The give to Templeton. Out across the 35 to about the 37-yard line. Bobcats continue just to pound it out. We're under 4 minutes, and the clock continues to run. Reno with all 3 timeouts remaining. The Bobcats with all 3 timeouts remaining.
Again, the Bobcats almost exclusively the last few times they've had the ball, they've just been going between tackle, the dive play.
Second and 5 for MSU. Wide right Bergman, wide left is Watson. Ohana in the center, Tatrault with the call. Give to Reinhardt up to about the 39-yard line. Bring up a 3rd down and 3 for the Cats.
For the Bobcats, that clock cannot run fast enough at this point in the game.
Well, another first down, and they would be in pretty good shape. It's going to be under 3 minutes before they get this play off. Tatrault on the option left, going to keep it, lowers his head and gets out across the 40 to about the 41, but he's going to be about a yard shy of the necessary yardage. The officials will call timeout. I believe they want to bring the sticks in, but I believe he is going to be short.
Well, to make the first down, they almost have to be at the 42-yard line. That ball is just sitting over the edge of the 41-yard line. So I know you're getting on in years, Dean, but I think your eyesight is still pretty good.
That's
from up
good.
Here.
I'm glad. I knew I'd been loading up on the carrots. Okay. Inches shy. The Cats want to go for it. What do the coaches say?
They're going to go for it.
It's a game of inches. Somebody said that once. Who was it said that, Dan?
I'm not sure who that was.
I know Yogi doesn't get credit for that one.
But in this case, you're definitely right. Gutsy call by the Bobcats.
Could they try to maybe draw Reno offsides? Is there something in the Bobcat playbook to do something like that?
Well, let's see. A go from the bone. Augerberg, Reinhardt, and Spokley. Reno stacked up in there in the middle. The give is to Augerberg, and he'll have the first down. Out to the 43-yard line. First down, Montana State.
Well, I think Reno was thinking like everybody else that the Bobcats have had so much success running to the left side. The inside linebackers for Reno both cheated a little bit over to the left side of the Bobcat line. The Bobcats ran to the right side, got some good blocking to pick up the first down.
Well, if Tatrault keeps his eye on the play clock, he has lots of time left, and he could get it under 2 minutes before the ball is snapped. Tatrault on the option give to Wilkinson, struggles and gets to about the 45-yard line. He'll only get a couple. And now the Wolfpack, I believe, going to start using timeouts. They are. Timeout called by Nevada Reno. The minute 53 to go. It's Montana State 17, Nevada Reno 14. Back after. We'll be right back. Bobcat with a second down call, second and eight from the Bobcat 45-yard line. On the give to Wilkinson, across the 50 into Reno territory near the 49-yard line. And the clock continues to run, and the Wolfpack will take, I believe, another timeout. They will. 1:43 remaining, Bobcats 17, Nevada Reno 14. Back after this from your network. Tatron with the call. Gives straight ahead to Wilkinson. He'll be very close to the first down sticks, but still going to be just a little bit shy depending on where they spot it. And Reno will use their last timeout. We'll keep it right here.
I think that we're in agreement today. Steve Hageberg is going to be our Bobcat MVP. Bozeman Trophy and Engraving each week honors the Bobcat Game MVP. Dennis and Lowell Springer of Bozeman Trophy and Engraving recognizing excellence. Congratulations for Bozeman Trophy and Engraving, the mark of excellence in awards and engraving.
Steve Hageberg with five carries for over 130 yards. 5'11", 175-pound freshman out of Glendive. So congratulations to Steve. On the fourth down, the Bobcats.
It appears, Dean, they've elected to punt here in the with fourth and one here.
A minute 36 on the clock.
Don't think anybody's gone home yet on this one.
Reno has used up all of their timeouts. The Bobcats fourth down and one. As Logan. Tony Logan back, the lone safety. Quinn Falk on to punt. Good snap, has time, and kicks it up to Logan at the 19, to the 20, and he is tackled right there. He was going absolutely nowhere. That was Frank Gottlick who got him. Frank Gottlick, the senior out of Polson, makes the tackle. And the Wolfpack now at the 19-yard line, the UNR 19, with a minute 29 to go and no timeouts. The only good news in that, they do have the wind at their back.
Every coach works on the two-minute offense drill, and we'll see. I know Reno is practicing. We'll see how this goes.
Slot left formation with Logan in the slot, Igu wide left. Zakeo drops, wants to throw, looking to the right side, throws it out to Williams, incomplete. Winnego over defending for the Bobcats. That'll be a second down with a minute 24. The Bobcats don't want him to get the bomb. try to play everything in front of them.
I would say, Dean, that they would have to go nearly 70 yards to get it within field goal range, 60 to 70 yards. And again, it's not a sure thing with Reno's kicker.
Wide left, Ego. Slot left, Logan. Williams and Folger split behind Zakeo. Davis, the tight end on the right side, he caught the big bomb earlier. Zakeo on the drop, wants to throw, comes deep down over the middle. There's Davis again, incomplete, over his head. He was out there. Third down and 10, a minute 19.
Secondary for the Bobcats lining up about 20 yards off the line of scrimmage. And as soon as that ball is snapped, they're backpedaling as fast as they possibly can. Do not want to let another long bomb get through like a couple of series ago.
Third and 10 for the Wolfpack. Logan wide right, wide to the left is Igu. Third and 10 for the Wolfpack, 19-yard line. Mateo with the drop, getting pressure from Wolf. Wolf has him. Ball is loose, ball it on. The Bobcats have it down at the 3-yard line. Corey Whitmer falls on it. Kevin Wolf got him, called it loose. Corey Whitmer's there. And baby, put this one in the books. The Bobcats are going to win this, baby.
Well, I think that was a question there. Zakeo thought he had to do something. It wasn't the right thing to do. Under tremendous pressure by Kevin Wolf, who broke through the middle of the line virtually untouched. I think that Reno trying to set up the screen pass, but it just wasn't there.
1:13 remaining. Bobcats 17, Reno 14. The Cats with the ball on the Reno 3-yard line. Moore wide left, Bergman wide right. Tatrol with the call. He'll keep it and just fall forward for maybe a yard. Reno can't stop it. They have no timeouts left. And the Bobcats will not be in any hurry to do much of anything, except, of course, score.
It would take about two more snaps, Dean, to get this one over with.
Clock continues to run, 53 seconds. Cats first place in the Big Sky Conference. Coming into this one and going out of this one. The Wolfpack at the top 10 of the nation, good portion of the year. They won't be there after this one, and they won't be in first. Tatrol again just lunging forward for not much. 30 seconds remaining. And let's see when they start the play clock. The Bobcats will not have to run another play. This one is history. The Bobcats are going to beat Nevada-Reno. Well, wait a minute. Now we take it back. They stop it. We have a Reno player who is injured. The fans don't like that. Shades of Notre Dame and Iowa many moons ago. Tatrol trotting over to the sidelines. Well, how about this for a ball game? Bobcats next week, Northern Arizona here. Their final home game of the season. The Cats in first place in the Big Sky Conference. And bringing in one of the preseason favorites, the Lumberjacks of Northern Arizona, kick off at 1. That one equally, I'm sure, will be a dandy.
Well, they're all, I think, from here on out, guaranteed to be dandies. The Bobcats obviously coming into this game, a big win last week off of Boise State. You know, were they for real? What's the deal? And I think that we know for sure that the Montana State Bobcats now are for real.
Reno is number 8 in the nation coming in, 5-1 overall, 2-1 in the league. They're now 2-2 in the league. The Cats will go even at 4-4, and more importantly, be 4-1 in the league. So they have started the clock again, and the Bobcats will not run another play, and this baby is history, as the Bobcats will beat Nevada-Reno this afternoon by a final of 17-14. Steve Hagerberg, our MVP, and another great performance by the Bobcats of MSU. Once again, the final, Montana State 17, Nevada-Reno 14. That's the ball game. Stay tuned for the post-game show. We'll check out what's going on.